It's 1954, and it's Mardi Gras. 1 million tourists are in New Orleans to celebrate. And in 1949, we were the first TV station to telecast the Mardi Gras parade. Take a close look at your screen. It shows costume prep for Mardi Gras balls. It has been reported that this particular designer designed 150 costumes and dresses for one ball alone. You'll see crowns made with 3,000 imported rhinestones and gowns studded with thousands of sequins, all hand-sewn.
And our next guest does not need a long introduction. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you. Oh, sorry.
back to your reality, back to 2011. No, Harry, you have been part of, you know, the acting scene and the world of television and movies for a very long time. And you were almost on Leave It to Beaver. What happened?
I was in the pilot of Leave It to Beaver. I was what turned out to be Eddie Haskell. And I was a working child actor at the time. And my folks said, it's okay for you to work from time to time, but if you get this series, you're going to have to leave regular public school and be in this special school, and we don't think that's right. So I did not lose the part.
There you go. Make it clear.
Yes.
You decided that it was not for you.
Well, my folks did.
Now, tell us about Spinal Tap.
Spinal Tap is this faux heavy metal rock band, which my colleagues, Michael McKean, Christopher Guest, and Rob Reiner and I created, which has had this incredible life. We're now nearing our third decade of service to the community. And we may be showing up again before too long.
Ooh,
louder than ever.
Louder than ever. We were actually watching some of it earlier today, and we were just laughing.
Good.
Now, part of your repertoire involves The Simpsons.
Yes, it does.
It does.
So I hear.
Could you share some of those voices with
us? Well, I just did.
But we
you
want,
missed it.
But we want some more.
I see. Well, this just in from the Channel 6 News. This is Channel 6.
We are.
What a coincidence.
We are in New Orleans.
Yes.
It's the magic wonderland
Indeed.
Of television.
Wow. I just walked through the mirror and back again.
I know it. Now, tell me about an event that you're here for.
Yes.
I understand that this is something good.
It's great. I say that with all modesty because it was created by my wife, Judith Owen. And
it's the smart thing to say, by the way.
Of course. See? But it's a Christmas sing-along that she created as a party originally at our house. She's a Brit, and she was sort of shocked that Christmas is here in the southern parts of the United States are warm, and so she decided to retaliate by having a group sing, and it's morphed into this show that we do here and in Los Angeles and in London, each city with local musician friends of ours. For the benefit of the New Orleans Musicians Clinic, we're doing two shows today at 4 and 8:30 at the Contemporary Arts Center, and it's a Leah Chase, Philip Manuel, Philip DeGree, David Torkanowski, Tom McDermott, John Cleary, the Pfister Sisters. I'm hoping I'm not leaving anybody out. All singing, and then we get the audience to sing and perform, and there are really crappy prizes for performance. So it's
there
it's
you
great
go. That's
fun.
The highlight of the whole
That is indeed the highlight.
Now, before you go, any other voices that you can share with us? Maybe Bill Clinton, George Bush? I know that
your
repertoire is extensive.
Yeah, God, it's been so long. Well,
I just want to say that I'm looking forward to the campaign season. It's one that I won't be participating in personally, although I will be collecting money just in case.
Typical politician, huh?
Indeed.
If you're listening, thank you so much
My
for
pleasure.
Being with
thank
us.
You.
We appreciate it. And give us a goodbye with, I don't know, something that you're feeling inspired to share.
So long, peasants.
There you go. Thank you so much for being with us. Again, today's sing-along is at 4 and then again at 8:30 at the Contemporary Arts Center on Camp Street.